If there is aught I can do... If there is aught I can do... If there is aught... Pray, pray.
Have your pick. What will it be today? Understood. I've a piece. What will it be today? Understood. If I've a piece. Have your pick. What will it be today? Understood.
Thank you. what's up, Morio? Morloco? Morlock Crusade? Oh, Morlock Crusade. Yeah, you can just throw your main pawn into the ocean, and that kills them. Oh shit, sorry, I missed your second question. How theoretically useful is the proximity of darkness? Against which opponents? Proximity of darkness? I honestly don't know what spell that is. Or skill, or what class has it. Maybe a little more details. Yeah, but the descriptions are misleading enough in English. Once you get translations into it, I'm sure it gets even worse.
What will it be today? Understood. If I have a piece, have your day. What will it be today? Understood.
Whatever. Fucking goddamn. Fuck, man. Fuck this. Oh, Dark Affinity? I don't know. Honestly, I never use it. But I think that pretty much all monsters are resistant to dark. So it kind of sucks. The best affinity is Holy Affinity. I actually saw something on GameFAQs about it today, about dark enchantment. They were saying the criticals do a lot of damage, but like I said, I've never really fucked with it. Yeah, good luck to you as well. If you're on PS4 and you need any items, I can give you some stuff to help you out. Also, I'm not really doing this for a challenge. It's actually easier solo sometimes, because you have, you get higher damage because there's solo augments that increase your damage. Plus, pawns are stupid sometimes and do stupid shit.
And now, have your pick. What will it be?
I don't know why the bishop wasn't respawned last time. Rested like 6 times all in all. Now 9 times, so he's gotta be respawned. Can't fucking make it through this without getting hit. Yeah. Fuck.
Thank you.
whatever. I don't really need armors anyway, just the gears.
And now we have your pick. What will it be? What will it be today? What will it be? Have your pick. What will it be today? Understood.
They both died at once? It's like, what the fuck? Fucked it up.
Thank you.
What will it be? What will it be today? What will it be today? Have your pick. What will it be? Understood.
Thank you.
pick up. Have your pick. What will it be? What will it be today? What will it be today? Have your pick. What will it be today? Understood.
Oops.
pig. And now, have your pig. What will it be today? What will it be today?
What the fuck? I don't understand why he's not responding like he usually does. Yeah. Bullshit. I'll say bullshit to that. Dude, fuck off. Stupid shit loot.
Understood. If the eye of a beast, what will it be? Understood.
Yeah, the ruinous, or the, that monocle thing. Yeah, it's a good way to get, cash early on. And what's up, man? It's good to see you again. I think it's called the Ruminator's Monocle. It sells for like 400k or something. Yeah, I'm playing Mystic Knight today. I think somebody wanted to see it like a day or two ago. I don't remember. But I was bored of the other stuff. What bow did you get? You got the rusted one or something different? What? So hard to see what's going on. Like, yeah. Really? Griffin something? Doesn't sound familiar. But I certainly haven't used all the items in the game. Pretty much just BBI stuff. And rusted stuff. What the fuck is going on right now? Oh, they're both dead. Jeez, it's so hard to see. Just fucking wings everywhere. What, that ogre gave you trouble? You can dodge roll out of his way, and a lot of times he'll jump off the edge. Easy way to kill him. Yeah. That's how it is. If you don't have enough strength or whatever, you just can't do any damage. I think you're just meant. I think the battles are just supposed to be meant to be like drawn out and hard. But there's stuff you can do. Like for that ogre, you might want to try bringing blast arrows. I don't know if you're able to buy them yet, though. Actually, whoops. I think you have to get to the part where you meet the Duke before you can buy blast arrows. But they solve most problems in the game. I don't know if you ever got that rusted bow, but Torpor really helps versus ogres because it slows them down a lot. And then, besides that, there's like, you could use throw blasts maybe? Honestly, I don't really remember how I took out those ogres when I was first playing. I know there's three in the ancient quarry that are a bitch. Yeah. The material to upgrade it is sold by in Grand Sorin. In the Black Cat, his shop is like in the slums, but he sells the materials you need to upgrade the rusted bow. You only have to get it to 2 stars, and then it'll do torpor. What Sith you're talking about. But yeah, Montebank at the Black Cat, he sells a bunch of stuff. When you talk to him, he has like three options. See what he has, or forge an item, or leave. So if you don't get those three items, you're not at the right place. Or those three options. Yeah, he sells those. Did you scroll down? Because the upgrade materials would be under materials, not under weapons. Yeah, I'm positive he sells them, because I bought them from him before. You know what? It's probably... you probably looked under materials. I think they're under tools, maybe. Because what does it need? Like a hoe or something? And like a... I forget what it needs, but... I think they're under tools. Go see.
See, I'm sure you'll find out.
Whoops. Here we are. Damn it, it's not what I wanted to do.
I'm sure you'll find out.
Oh, it's under other. Here it is. So I think you need like a spade. I forget what you need, but it's here. Maybe a trowel. It's under other. That's where you get the upgrade stuff for the rusted bow. Thank you. Hey, D-Curse, you still there? Yo, did you hire any pawns? Or are you just playing with you and your main pawn? You should try hiring my level 10 pawns. Because they won't hurt your experience, but they should help you out. Oh. Then why are you having trouble if you have two OP pawns? Can't they just kill the ogre for you? Oh yeah, you're not on PS4? I forgot. Well, when I play, first of all, I gift myself, like, a rusted bow, so that I have torpor. And then I just rush through the main story to get to post-game, and then I level all my vocations. There's like a trick in the Noble Quarter, once you get to post-game, to level your vocations up quickly. And then once I have everything leveled, then I go to BBI and level up to 200. Really, like, the weapon makes all the difference. Like, if you have a weapon that can damage stuff, then you're good. If you don't have a weapon that can damage stuff, then you're fucked. So I would say go on like a Steam forum and ask for just like a basic weapon. somebody will probably send you like a UR dragon drop or something. Those are one of the best giftable weapons. Suffer through it, and then your next time through, you could gift yourself some stuff if you play, if you make another account. But those DLC weapons from Montebank are pretty good for what they are. So depending on what class you are, they can be useful. Fuck me, I couldn't see anything. God, first form diamond is so fucking annoying. Like, I haven't played through the game without, like, twinking myself in, like, so many years. So I don't even really remember what I did. I know I would always go to BBI and get 4 rings of Perseverance first, but that's kind of like OCD, and you probably don't want to do that. But there's like a trick where you can go to BBI, you get the Void Key, and then you get the Moonbeam Gem from the Warrior's Respite, and then you can use that gem to get a Ring of Perseverance, or Perseverance, which gives you 50% extra discipline points. So I did that, and then if you hard mode reset, you can do it again. So I did that 4 times, got 2 for me and 2 for my pawn, and it makes your job locations level up faster. But it takes a couple hours probably to do that 4 times. I don't know if you'd want to do that. I think that makes the game easier once you have those rings, because then you can buy more skills and stuff quicker. But honestly, I've never played without them, so I don't really know. What will it be? And besides that, the The queen's outfit that you get as DLC, it should be in your inventory once you get to Grand Soren. That's like a really strong armor. So you could use that on either you or your pawn. It doesn't look that good, but it's pretty strong for the beginning of the game. Yeah, you gotta buy skills.
What will it be today? Have your pick. What will it be today? Understood.
Hey, what's up, Captain Sandwich? It's going pretty good.
If I have a beast, have your pick. What will it be today? Understood. A beast. What will it be today? Understood.
I would, but I can't. It's a BBI item, so you can't gift it. The guy who sells it is Baroque or whatever. But you gotta do a quest for him. I think you have to do that quest to kill 5 Garm. There should be a quest on like that main notice board. I think that's the one that gets you rancid meat from him. from Barak. He moves around. Once you beat Diamond, he'll be in the, once you beat Diamond, he'll move to where Ulra is, like in the town area or whatever. But before that, I think he's usually in the Garden of Ignominy. I don't know how to say it. That's where you first see him. I think that's where he is on your first run through. He moves around though. He moves around not like Reynard, where you'll miss him a lot. He moves around like you'll see him a lot. Like he teleports. He's always in the Warrior's Respite. If you go from the Garden of Ignominy, you go through that door, like the main door where you have to use the void key to get through it. And then once you get to that part where the stairs are going down, and that's where you have to go down those stairs, you can also go up the stairs, and that's the Warrior Respite there. And Barak should be in there. He only sells like 3 baits at a time though, and then you gotta rest to get him to restock. Yeah, he's always at the Respite, and also the Arisen's Refuge is like the pretty much the same as the Warrior's Respite, just different. He teleports all around, like you'll see him at the Warrior's Respite, and then you run past, and you'll see him at the Arisen's Refuge. He's like all places at once. What level are you now? Did you play any more? Are you still 62?
Thank you.
thinking a couple more runs, and then I will purify.
And now, have your pick. What will it be? What will it be today?
None of them are hitting. There we go. Is he getting hit now? What the hell? Didn't work at all. He's definitely modeled off the Grim Reaper. He's supposed to be the Grim Reaper. He's kind of annoying though, because he one hit kills everything. And you can't, you send your pawns right to the rift, you can't revive them. That's what I did, like, my first runs through BBI, just run away from him. He has really high defenses, too, so, like, you probably won't be able to hurt him much on the first go. Pretty lucky with these gears though. No, we're talking about death. He was saying you just run away from him, and I was like, yeah, pretty much. Until you're like really strong, then you can fight him. Cause you gotta, if you do over a bar of damage to him, then he'll disappear. So you gotta try and do as much damage as you can really quick, so he'll leave before he kills your pawns. Or you. Yeah, death is a bastard. He's supposed to, like, hunt you. It's supposed to be like you're being hunted by death. Just a little bit too late. Yeah, I hate rolling in there because you get drenched. But it's better than getting hit by an eliminator. That's what the ox guys are called, eliminators. I don't need this. So one more, then I'm gonna purify what I got. I think the bishop should be respawned by now. both died on top of each other. Nice gear. Hey, what's up, Trouser Stealer? Funny name. Yeah, Mystic Knight is really strong. My stats are like really high because I'm using kind of situational augments like autonomy and bloodlust. Those really increase your damage a lot, but you have to be solo and at night. So bloodlust wears off if you take too long. Shit. I think I'm gonna get wrecked by this. Red block. Oh yeah, gears. So you're on Next Game Plus now? Yeah, those bandits on hard mode are tough. Did you go to BBI before you went to Next Game Plus, or you just did the main story? I see. Yeah, I think most people recommend like level 80. Before you start BBI. So by the time you finish your next playthrough, you'll probably be ready. Those assassin augments are really good. That's where you get bloodlust and autonomy. Nah, it's the same in New Game Plus. New Game Plus just gives you... It gives you a Rift Stone that goes right to the UR Dragon from Cassardis. And it lets you buy some extra stuff. I think you can buy, like, port crystals. You can buy extra port crystals. See how many gears I have. Pray, permit me. Only 46. Get anything.
Pray, permit me to pray.
It's not like leveling up that'll make you stronger. It's more your gear. But I guess once you get once you unlock like Lincian Sight, which is like the zoom in skill, that one is really useful. Like if you can hit people before they notice you, then you get like a really big damage bonus. And it's easy to do that if you have that Lincian Sight. Well, I think I told somebody else this, but what I did when I was assassin and I was leveling up, like on my strength build, I had leveled from 10 to 200 as assassin. I got the force hatchet from the Black Cat, and what it does is it powers up every time you get a hit, and once it's maxed out, like you glow like bright blue or something, and it makes all your hits ignore armor, like it makes all your hits really strong, and it affects your bow side as well. So I would charge up with Force Hatchet, and then I would use Rusted Bow on my other side, and so I would Torpor them with Rusted Bow, and it also made the Rusted Bow do good damage having the Force Hatchet charged up. So that was like my strategy playing as Assassin when I was low level. You just have to be careful, because if you get hit when you're charged up, then you lose all your stamina and you get stunned. I don't know, in Next Game Plus, can you buy blast arrows right away? Because blast arrows are always good. But for, yeah, it's like Cage Fury. I used Cage Fury on my sorcerer, too, before. For, like, really good skills for assassin, like, Gale Harness for daggers, it makes you like 20% faster. Masterful Kill, it's basically like a perfect block, but you don't have to time it. You can just hit it, and then next time you get hit, as long as you don't move, it'll do it. When I play Assassin, I bring a sword and daggers, because it's sometimes you need to double jump, and I usually just switch to sword if like it's a really big battle and it's tough. Yeah, range any bow class can use blast arrows besides magic archer. Magic archer is the only one that can't. And then you want 100 kisses obviously for assassin. I'm on stuff you get 1.5 times damage bonus, except striders get 2.5 times bonus when they climb. Well, for Mystic Knight, it's called Reflect. It's a core skill. For fighters, and I think assassins can do it too, I'm not positive. It's called Deflect, I think. You have to get that core skill, and then you can do it. Or if you're talking about the dagger skill, it's called Masterful Kill. It's not actually a perfect block, but it kind of works similar, I guess. Yeah, once you have deflect, you just have to press block right when they hit you. I think you get like 15 frames window to do it. I guess I should get rid of these rings. I was gonna just reload my save, but whatever. Yeah, Masterful Kill is nice. And like it'll hurt stuff that you can't really even hurt otherwise. Like even if your damage is low and you're doing like no damage to something, if you use Masterful Kill, it'll still do pretty good damage. Master rings are such a bitch to get, man. I'm about to go get lunch, but when I come back, I'll use my assassin account and I can show you some stuff, I guess. I'm not sure how much they'll relate to like early game, but you can at least see the skills. Alright, cool. So I'll be back in like an hour. See ya for now.